Looking to know what are the functional groups in organic chemistry? You've come to the right video. Hi, I'm Dr. K and welcome to ChemSimplified. In this video, we'll go through the 13 functional groups you will need to know for an introductory chemistry course. As mentioned, there are 13 groups altogether, and 1912 cake is the key. There's one group that starts with C, 9 that starts with A, 1 that starts with K, and 2 that starts with E. And here's our cake. 1C, carboxylic acid, 9 A's, alkane, alkene, alkyne, arene, alkyl halide, alcohol, aldehyde, amine, and amide. And then we move on to our K, 1K, ketone, and our 2 E's, ether and ester. So these are our 13 groups. We're going to move on to see how each of these groups look like. These are the functional groups. I'll go through each of them in detail after this. I can group these functional groups in this manner. Do you see what's in common for each of these groupings? Let's look at the first grouping. They are all hydrocarbons except for the fifth one, alkyl halide, is a hydrocarbon derivative. Hydrocarbons are compounds that consist of only carbons and hydrogens. So let's focus on the first three, alkane, alkene, and alkyne. These three are quite similar, aside from the spelling. They are the triplets. They differ only by one alphabet, A for alkane, E for alkene, and Y for alkyne. So think of it this way. A comes before E, E comes before Y. So the number of bonds between the C and the C, it's single bond in alkane, double bond in alkene, and triple bond in alkyne. AEY, 1, 2, 3. Next, we have arene, which is also called an aromatic group. At introductory chemistry level, the arene you will encounter will be benzene ring, which consists of 6 carbons with alternating single and double bonds. Then we have alkyl halide, which is the hydrocarbon derivative. It's actually an alkane, except for it's missing one hydrogen, and that's replaced with a halogen like fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. Moving on to the next grouping, what do these guys have in common? It's that C double bond O group, right? They are actually called carbonyl. If you attach OH next to a carbonyl group, then you get yourself a carboxyl group. The difference is only N and X. So what's the difference between aldehyde and ketone? Look closely between aldehyde and ketone. They both have C double bond O. The difference is that aldehyde has a hydrogen right next to that C double bond O, whereas ketone on the left and on the right, on both sides of that carbonyl group, are going to be carbons. Next, we have carboxylic acid and ester. What's the difference between these two? Well, the difference is that carboxyl group is present in carboxylic acid, and that H in carboxylic acid is replaced with a C in ester. So, functional group for carboxylic acid is COOH. Functional group for ester is C double bond O, OC. And last in that group that also has C double bond O is amide. The difference between amide and the rest is that aside from that C double bond O, next to it is attached to a nitrogen which has 3 bonds. So that's the difference between all of these carbonyl groups. Okay, next we move on to the next grouping. Alcohol and carboxylic acid. Now they are both they both have something in common, which is the OH group. By the way, OH group has its own name, it's called hydroxyl group. So if you look at the difference between alcohol and carboxylic acid, they both have OH. The only difference is carboxylic acid has an extra C double bond O. Next, we look at ether and ester. Ether and ester are spelled quite similar, so don't get confused. Ether is E-T-H-E-R, ester is E-S-T-E-R. So in this case, two alphabets are different. So don't get confused. But they're kind of similar like alcohol and carboxylic acid. So these two, they have carbon, oxygen, carbon, right? In both sides. But if you look at ester, one of that C is actually a carbonyl group. So that's the difference between these two. Last but not least, we look at our nitrogen compound, which is amine and amide. So they are also spelled quite similarly. So the difference between the spelling is amine is spelled with an N, amide is spelled with a D. And the difference between the two in terms of their functional group is that amide has a carbonyl group, whereas amine doesn't have a carbonyl group. They both have nitrogen, which has three single bonds, but in amide, there's a carbonyl group right next to that nitrogen. And that ends the intro to the 13 functional groups. If you wish to explore more on each of these groups, please watch the How to Recognize Functional Groups series. I'll put the link on top and in the description box below. If you enjoyed this video and feel that it is valuable in introducing the 13 functional groups, share it with your friends or anyone who might benefit from it. Also, do subscribe and click on that bell icon so you'll get notified on new videos. For more info or practice questions, please head over to ChemSimplified.com. I'll post the blog link in the description box. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.